Hey everybody, Tom Barnes, Chicago Scene, downtown at the Chicago Architecture Center. And of all my years living in Chicago, I've never been here. I'm sad to say, I've never been here. It's right on Wacker Drive in Michigan where you can go get the architectural tour, you get your tickets in here. But they have this new exhibit called Energy Revolution. It's about how the buildings have changed throughout the 19th, 20th, and 21st century in terms of keeping all things energy efficient. I'm gonna talk to Eve, also get a little tour of the space in this amazing downtown Chicago exhibit. It explains how Chicago's changed throughout the years. That's the Chicago Scene, the Chicago Architecture Center. All right, we're in the City Model Experience where they have all sorts of fun things happening here. I'm here with Sinway Mendoza. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, thanks, Tom.
So, what's going on behind you? Why don't you explain what's happening behind you? Because I think this is a very interesting and wonderful exhibit.
Yeah, dynamic, you could say. So behind me is the City Model Experience. It's a 4,000 building model of the city of Chicago. It's iconic. A lot of people in the city know about it. It used to be where we were originally in the Santa Fe building, but when we moved here in 2018 and became the Chicago Architecture Center, we made it bigger. And it's, like I said, it's over 4,000 buildings, and every time there is buildings in the loop that are updated, we update the model. Like, for example, 1000M, which is Helmut Jahn's last building he designed, which is 1000 Michigan Avenue, is already up.
And that's not supposed to be completed for another couple of years.
So yeah, the construction has restarted, but it's not up yet. But the model of it is already in the Chicago City Model.
And behind you too, it also just goes through the entire history of Chicago from the fire to the World's Fair and everything up till right now with the different interactive lights on separate parts of downtown. It's just a really beautiful model of the city.
Yeah, that's right. So what it does is essentially gives the history of Chicago and why we are the city of architecture, why we consider ourselves one of the most important architecture cities in the world. You know, our friends in New York are, you know, they like to claim, but the first skyscraper was built in Chicago, right?
Oh, well, we know that, yeah.
The tallest building in the U.S. for a long time was the Sears Tower or Willis Tower.
Sure.
You know, we have the John Hancock that was built shortly before the Sears Tower. You know, what else can you say? The, you know, Jeannie Gang, St. Regis down the way here. We're in a Mies van der Rohe skyscraper right now. You know, Chicago really is the city of architecture any way you look at it. One, going down the river on one of our boats at the Chicago's First Lady, you'll find out real fast. We are the most important architectural city in America.
Right, and I think people lose sight of the fact that Chicago is just more than just downtown. There's bungalows and the two flats and everything else, and there's exhibits here where you guys walk through the importance of that and how it is important to remember what they were purposely built for in the past and now and here in the future.
That's right. Housing for a Changing Nation goes through that. We go through the two flat. Our two flats, the way they were meant to be, are disappearing. They're becoming single family homes in a lot of neighborhoods. You know, that can become an issue because working class families, what they were meant for, are losing places to live within our city. So Housing for a Changing Nation goes through how architecture and design is trying to tackle issues like that. What can we build the future of architecture in terms of homes to service the future of the way people live in the U.S.?
Right, and you have just these wonderful examples of like workers' cottage, the two flats, the bungalows, the courtyard buildings. And if you've lived in the city at all from your 20s for a brief moment or even as later on, odds are you lived in one of those courtyard buildings or those two flats or workers' cottage, because some of those were popular in different neighborhoods like Wicker Park or Bucktown workers' cottages or the courtyard buildings in Ravenswood and Lincoln Square. It's just a wonderful exhibit.
Yes, that's right. I'm one of those people who lived in a three flat, and I actually lived in one of the buildings in Lincoln Park that was knocked down recently, which is also an issue. We're seeing some historic, you know, over 100-year-old buildings in neighborhoods like Lincoln Park that are being knocked down that, you know, have a lot of heritage. Again, some of the stuff that at the Chicago Architecture Center, we work with some of our partners like Preservation Chicago to highlight that, hey, this is an issue. We should talk, have a larger conversation, and bring lots of parties together to discuss these types of issues.
And you also have these great examples of maybe redeveloping old vacant storefronts to turn them into these community not community centers, but community living areas, where you have an example out in LA of what's going on, but here you have some examples as well of what could happen in Chicago, especially with a lot of these old storefronts like the Kmart buildings that have since long been gone here.
That's right. You know, architects are redesigning, you know, having an idea. It's like, hey, we have this vacant, you know, Kmart sitting in this neighborhood. Why don't we use it? And we use it to house people, right? There's a lot of empty space that's sitting out there that can literally be used, you know. Even here in the downtown area, some of the conversations that we've had here at the Chicago Architecture Center, it's like, we have vacant office buildings. How about making that residential? In downtown, that's happening already. You see old office buildings that in the 80s maybe housed offices that are becoming residential.
And speaking of the offices and everything else in the skyscrapers, Eve, who curates the exhibit upstairs about the energy and how we want to move away from gas-powered energy to electric energy and making buildings more efficient. I'm talking to her next, but I get the general gist of what's happening upstairs in the upstairs exhibit, right?
Yeah, that's right. Energy revolution goes through that. It's like, what, you know, the climate emergency, right? People talk about climate change. Well, it is an emergency, but energy revolution also wants to give people an idea. Architecture and design has a place in that, and so do we. What can we do? Well, like you just said, there's twins to gas-powered things that we can use electric energy, right? It's already happening with vehicles, right? Like, you know, how often do you see electric vehicles on the road now? You know, there's a lot of stuff that we're making a move towards it, but I think energy revolution will show and shows that, you know, we need to probably do it a little quicker, and architecture and design has a big part in that.
Right, and you showcase some of the best architects in the city here on the wall downstairs and upstairs as well with all the energy efficient. It was a pleasure chatting with you. I think I'm going to head upstairs and talk with Eve here in a second.
Thanks, Tom. See you soon.
All right, thank you. All right, so I'm on the second floor of the center, and I'm here in the Energy Revolution exhibit, and I'm here with my friend Eve. How are you, Eve?
I'm great, thanks.
So, Eve, what is this space that we're standing in here, and why should people pay attention to it, and why it's important?
So this is the Skyscraper Gallery of the Chicago Architecture Center hosting a huge exhibition called Energy Revolution. Why people should pay attention: this is a call to action to architects, engineers, developers, civic leaders, and everyday citizens, mm-hmm. that the climate crisis is actually an emergency. And so this exhibition tells you why it's an emergency and gives us kind of ways forward so that we can work our way out of the climate crisis that we're in right now.
Right, we have a couple of examples of build outs, or you have a fancier name than I can remember, of prototypes of the different buildings that Chicago has from the 19th, 20th, and 21st century, specifically showing the width of the walls and the insulation and why it's such an important thing and why so many buildings, because of a certain era, maybe are not so energy efficient, but we're working on it.
That's true, and actually the most recent building, we just, Doug Farr and Associates just broke ground, the Academy for Global Citizenship. It's the 21st century building example that shows Chicago kind of at the forefront as a leader in sustainable architecture, and you can see inside the exterior walls all the components that add up to making it such an energy efficient building.
Yeah, it's really an eye-opening exhibit just because you have all the skyscrapers that are from around the world, not just here in Chicago, but because we're the birthplace of it. We have shown the world what we can do and what the world has done with it. I mean, what's your favorite part in this exhibit? I mean, you have different materials that show what can go into the insulation process, the different types of buildings. What's your favorite part about this spot?
Certainly the material wall and the prototypes are two of my favorite parts. And also the infrared projection on the Hancock building is one of my favorites. You know, the beloved Hancock, it's one of the buildings Chicago's known for. Infrared photography is an interesting way to show the energy performance of a building. And so we're doing a projection onto our
heat. Right, on cue, as you said it, it's lit up.
Yeah, it's lit up on cue, so you can start to understand what's happening inside the building and then learn through the exhibition what we can do to either retrofit older buildings or build newer, more efficient buildings so that we don't leak energy from the outside.
And how long is this exhibit going to be part of this the center?
It's open through October 17th, so that previous weekend is Open House Chicago, and so we're going to stay open and close the day after Open House Chicago closes.
Fantastic. And if people want to come by or learn more about it, should they hop on a website?
Yeah, the CSA website, and then it features the Energy Revolution exhibit, and so then you can learn all about the exhibit, and definitely I think this is an in-person experience, so I'd invite everyone to come down and check it out.
Awesome. Thank you very much for the great talking with you, Eve.
Thanks. Thank you.
What a great exhibit here at the Chicago Architectural Center, T-B-A-R-N-A-S at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's T-Barnes at WGNTV.com. We'll see you guys later. Take care.